Hey boys and girls, Mike here, One Go ShortPlay. Today we're playing Crude Busters for the Sega Mega Drive. Love this game. Really, really cheap and ropey game. But I love it. First played this on the arcade back in, oh god knows when. When I was at school, there was a shop by the station, Farmer Station, that had this. And it was great. It's clearly a data east game, it's clearly a pro seeder of Dragon Ninja. Mega Drive version is a bit ropey from the arcade game, but it's pretty good in a ropey kind of way. So we've got a basic hit attack, we've got a throw attack, and we've got, I'm sure we can do something with that wall. Yeah, I'm sure we can. Oh yeah, we can hit it. Okay. Yeah, there's a shop at the end of the road that you could, you know, sweet shop, you go to on the way to the station. I'm usually better at this, I'm just too busy talking. I can get all of them without taking a hit. In fact, I completed this on the Mega Drive. Unfortunately for me, it was with a cheat on. So, not really completed, but I cheated the hell out of it and beat it. Just with save points, basically. I only took a hit throughout the playthrough. Never recorded it, just wanted to see if I could do it. I might have took a couple of hits, because some bits are really tough. After that, oh, yeah, see, it's like, it's clearly built on the Dragon Ninja engine. It's clearly got similar graphic style to Dragon Ninja. Sorry, I call it Dragon Ninja. Most of you will know it's Bad Dudes. It's a long story, but over in the UK, a lot of the 8-bit versions were just called Dragon Ninja because the Dragon Ninja bit featured prominent in its name. Well, should have kept that. These guys are nasty. So, get off me, get off me, get off me! I hate those things. Really make me angry. What you need is something to throw at him, like a dude. A bad dude, in fact. Okay, it's bad, and he was a dude. Uh oh. Hey, what the f? I didn't know you could do that, I forgot you could pick that up. Not that. Yeah. A lot of pick em up and throw stuff, which Dragon Ninja, of course, bad dudes, of course, never had. But it's like the advance on their bad dudes kind of platform engine. And the platform levels are alternating a bit. And I'm jump kicking them because I'm actually frightened of those guys. They're really nasty. Really difficult for everybody's. All these guys are nasty too. Yeah, it's that. Oh, you nasty man. Bad, bad man. And it does feel a bit like Dragon Ninja. I think Dragon Ninja, Bad Dudes, is a better game for its age. You can see this has got a kind of an inherent ropiness to it, which, you know, Bad Dudes have. Sorry, when I say Bad Dudes or Dragon Ninja, I'm referring to the same game. This just always reminds me of it. That shop had this, and before this it had eSport. And I first properly played eSport there. I really got into it. I only recently realised, I thought the Spectrum and Amiga versions were bad versions, bad ports. And they're not great ports, but I actually forgot that the arcade game isn't that nice to play. Could be Dixie's too, but maybe doing an old save, isn't it? Yeah, maybe doing an injustice there. Yeah, the arcade restart's a little bit ropey too. I guess it was quite early games. I mean, eSwat and Dragon Ninja were both ported to the 8-bits, not the 16-bits. I know eSwat was ported to 16-bits too. But the Mega Drive version of eSwat is, it's so much better, I think, than the arcade version. And all the other ports, they made a whole new game out of that. Talking about eSwat, I'm playing. I'm talking about Bad Dudes, I'm playing Crude Buster. Crude Buster? Two Crude Dudes. That's what I'm playing that as Crude Buster. That's why it's come up in C. But it will probably come up in Two Crude Dudes as well. And by T, I will probably be dying for a go of this. So I might even play it again. It's pretty much exactly the same game. Just different regions, I think. Get off me, get off me! I'm sure shaking and pressing the buttons is nothing. I'm now. This guy you can actually beat with a bit of tactic. I'm just going in, I'm just hammering the controls because it's a 10-minute video and I want to see, you know, some games I can. I don't want to be taking the time. How ropey is that snake? How badly animated and badly drawn is that snake? I mean, not that the baddies are particularly well drawn. He looks a bit kissed, doesn't he? See, it's like, I'm bad. It's straight out of Dragon Ninja. And it feels like the same engine that's built on. It all goes a bit Final Fight-y. I do like the music though. that. Now, each one of these cannons is a tiny little pink pelt, so you basically got to hammer the heck out of the machine. I think the best way is just to hit it. And then we've got a few, I think, yeah, that's it. But it takes ages drinking for a tiny bit of health. I should pause the game. See, that's still a bit... Okay, sorry about that. All went a bit wrong there. Oh no, the controls are gone. Oh wow, I think this means, yeah. When it's putting together one of the other videos, it sometimes starts playing. This music's quite iconic. It starts playing the video when it's finished, and it's inevitably in the middle of another video. These guys are huge. Very weird walk animations. Not very competently done. They're quite competently drawn, just not animated. I think the arcade version is better. I think they just, you know, maybe doing the 16-bit home ports, just pulled frames out to make them a bit cheaper on the old disc or cartridge space. Final Fight on the Amiga, and looking at you, that was my head and how many frames you pulled out of that game. Nasty. These guys are nasty. Get off me. Look at these guys. The guys who spit on you. There's some dudes who spit on me. I think it might be these. If they get on a wall, I think they spit on me. Might be different colour variants of them that do that. Oh, come on. It's not fun. That's just boring. I can pick that wall up and fling it. I'll bet that'll be fun. Yeah, I think the arcade version's got a little bit more depth to it. And a lot more animation to it. I still love it. I mean, you can see how ropey this is. It's got that kind of Captain America and the Avengers ropiness, you know, that that's got. I still love it. I love both those kind of different states those dogs. They're really nasty and funny. Yeah, they're like the little fat dudes. The little punchbacks, they just hook onto you. Drain your energy. Oh yeah, that. See, that sort of thing is fun. And that sort of thing is fun. Just the ease with which you can fling people around. It's fun. Who wouldn't want to be able to do that? If I ever did like a Double Dragon style brawler, I would definitely, well, I don't know, but I would definitely like to get some people flinging it so far. The one that make at the moment does that in the Streets of Rage sense. You know, they can grab them as well. But, there's something more abrupt about the throws in this. This guy's got a technique to kill him as well. It's not this. But I can't be bothered remembering it and figuring it out. And so I'm just going to hammer him until he dies. Or until I die. There we go. Ooh, yes, please. Let's have some of them. In fact, I reckon this has probably got a limited amount of coke cans in it because I've got a limited amount of time. Yeah, I don't want that. Oh, I blew up my coke cans. Oh. Mr. Zed, get off of me, have some of this, put you out of into his head. That's what I'm sure there's some bad guys supposed to fall off that, or jump off that. It might be the arcade version. I'm trying to throw upwards. So I smack him with this. Oh, that's pretty good. Didn't expect that to happen. I think he just comes across a set amount of times. Yeah, it's a good dog. Oh, nicely done, man. Nicely done, can I? Yes. Get out of my game. Sorry. I have full-blown conversations with these bad guys sometimes. Ooh. Jesus. Totally me in one move. See, he's not very well drawn, is he, at this stage, isn't he? He's a nice idea though. It's just a bit ropey on the artwork. Although, that ropiness has a certain charm of its own. And that. And that. And that. And a bit of that. And some of that. And maybe some of that too. Anyway, time's up. Excellent game for kind of a ropey. Side-scroller platformer, Crude Buster, close it over there. Thanks for watching.